It's cool because I never was able to actually see before. There's a delay. All right, do we see us live? I just want to make sure we are on. We're good. I don't see us yet.
Yep, we're live.
We are live. Yay.
We are
Oh,
live.
super cool. Yay. All right. First of all, let me minimize this. I don't want to get distracted by comments. I just want to make sure we are live. We are sticking. Shoot.
We are sticking.
We are, yeah,
I show us live. I'm watching us.
Are we moving?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm not going to look at my phone. You just tell me because there's
Wait,
I'm
you're
having
talking.
some issues.
Yeah,
Okay. All
you're talking.
right. Very cool. All right. Hey, everyone. I'm super excited to be here with the amazing Ferny. Ferny, I always want to say Ceballos. Like it's Ceballos or Ceballos or
Ceballos.
Ceballos. But everyone, you guys, I'm so happy to have Ferny with us today. Ferny, as I call him, is the king of attraction marketing. But honestly, I want to just, I'm really excited about my community here getting a chance to get to know you. Ferny's been a mentor to me for, oh my gosh, the past, I think, 18 months. And honestly, if you know a little bit of my story, you know that I've been in network marketing for 6 years. And 2 years ago, I really got the urge to just learn the game of online marketing. What is it all about? And you guys, it's so important to understand marketing. It's so important to understand attraction marketing so we don't have to hit our heads against the wall trying to, figure out how do we move away from our warm market. And so that's where I invited Fernie on today because I really, really want you guys to get to know Fernie, his amazingness, and
Amazing.
understand, yes, his amazingness, and understand really where he has learned it. And he has been so successful and has, I think, created the most success stories in this space of teaching home-based business entrepreneurs how to build their business online very effectively. And so people look at me and they say, Julie, how have you had so much success this past year? And I say, well, it's because I've surrounded myself with amazing mentors such as Bernie and Tim Irway, Kate McShay, right? And so I'm really proud and very honored that you're taking the time out of your day to be here because I know how busy you are. And so very instrumental in my success. And so Fernie, I have to publicly say thank you for teaching me how to do it the right way. And so really I just want to dive in and start asking you some questions. And as you guys are popping in, please show Fernie some love. I'm going to be looking over here on the phone because I know I have quite a few people over here. And of course, my phone is wanting to be frozen. But we have 50 people on and growing. So people
Yeah,
are saying hello.
I see it's okay. So,
We're okay. All
thank you. Well, Julie, before we go on, I just want to thank you for having me. I'm the one that's honored to be in front of your audience. I'm honored to have played a role in your development over the past couple years, as it relates to taking your business online and kind of doing things a little differently. You were already online, I should say. We just kind of showed you a way to kind of level up,
Yes.
and we're there with you through that journey. But you did the work. You know, all we did was kind of shine the light towards where you needed to go and what you needed to do and what you needed to pick up and what you needed to put down. And you did the work, and the work isn't easy. It's a very different approach, and that's, you know, in many circles of network marketing is frowned upon. But not only did you have the courage, you know, to go down this path, you proved that attraction marketing works and can work in a massive way. And so, for that, I thank you, because without you doing the work, you know, I wouldn't, be able to do what I do.
Yes, and I've learned so much from you, and you're right. What you learn, I feel like sometimes people get in learning mode, learning mode, learning mode, but you have to implement and take action no matter how nervous you are, no matter what that fear is, you have to move forward in taking that, consistent action to be able to start seeing results, right? And I remember our first conversation, Ferny, before I have you share your background, is you guys, I came to Ferny and I was crying. I'll be like fully vulnerable here and all out. And Ferny was so amazing because he took that and he said, Julie, you always have a breakdown right before you have a breakthrough. And I think the reason for my emotions was because I was learning, 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 but I didn't know how to apply it. And that's really where, again, I just want to thank you for showing, for leading me, taking me in that direction by hand and showing me the way. And so, Fernie, I would love for you if you could just start out by telling us, sharing your background with my audience here and how you really got started with online marketing and particularly like how you learned attraction marketing. And then if you could share that pivotal turning point in your life of what made you want to commit to this industry. So if you could just share a little bit of your background so they get to know you, that would be awesome.
Absolutely. Wow. Okay. Well, I was, I'm going to start from the very beginning. I was born in East Los Angeles, to Mexican immigrant parents. And so I was, and had a wonderful family life. And so as a result, even though I grew up in a poor area and ourselves, pretty poor, all credit goes to my parents, and I did really well in school. I was the nerd. I chose to put my face in books instead of joining a gang, basically. And
Yes, you're
so,
very smart, by the way. You guys don't know how smart he is. He's smart.
in long story short, I had the privilege and honor of going to the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, studied engineering there at MIT. And so went away from home, went all the way to Boston from LA, first time ever leaving LA in my life. Never seen snow, all that stuff. And it was a whole new world, and it was awesome. And from there, had an incredible time. I studied computer science, electrical engineering, and graduated from there. My family got to go out there and see their boy graduate. And then, I was offered a job, and I went to work in the aerospace industry, particularly in the defense sector. So basically, I worked on top secret space stuff for the government, mainly missile defense, had top secret clearances. You think everything was hunky-dory and everything was like, wow, Bernie, you are the epitome of the American dream. You went to school, got good grades, got a really good job, and that's the perception on the outside. But the reality for me is that I wasn't happy. Engineering did not fulfill me. It wasn't my calling. And there's people I know some of the most brilliant, smartest people in the world who I went to school with, and they love it. They geek out in this stuff, and I simply couldn't geek out anymore. It just, it wasn't in me. I wasn't passionate about it. And especially when I went to work in corporate America and having to kind of deal with just, corporate politics, and especially because it's government, it's very, bureaucratic. And so it wasn't my deal. And all I had to do was just look down the hall at the, middle-aged, balding fat guy.
Right.
I look into the future and go, oh man, this is not what I want to do. So within a very short period of time, I knew, realized that I did not want to do that for the rest of my life, and started searching. And initially I went to grad school because I was like, what else?
Oh,
Grad school, and at
there
grad
you
school
go.
is where, am I connect, did I disconnect?
Yeah, you were really like froze for like a
Okay,
few
yeah. So,
seconds. You're good.
all right, cool. And from grad and at grad school is where I met somebody who eventually a year later ended up inviting me to a board plan, and I thought it was a meeting for a startup that he wanted to work on, an internet startup, and it turned out that someone started drawing circles, and it was and I joined network marketing very shortly thereafter. I did not want to join network marketing. I had a negative view of network marketing. But here, the funny thing is that I was so ready to like move on from my job, And at that point, no one else had offered me any other opportunity to kind of alleviate this massive, you know, pain in my life. Right. And don't take me wrong, it was a great job. I made good money and everyone was proud of me. I just wasn't happy. And after that much, you know, study and the sacrifices that my parents made, it just, I felt like I was doing, you know, dishonoring, even though they didn't know it, I felt like I was dishonoring them by not being happy with my career choices. So I was like, freak it, let's do this. And so I jumped into network marketing. You know, I started building up a team in network marketing, doing it the old school way over the course of 9 months. And even though I hated every moment of it, what kept me going was the promise of, you know, financial freedom and being able to like leave my job. And so I hated every aspect of network marketing except the promise of it.
Right.
And so, but eventually, you know, the people couldn't duplicate me. And so my team basically started quitting. By this, you know, start of the second year, 90% of my team had basically quit because they couldn't duplicate. And I didn't know how to teach them how to duplicate. I didn't have the skills to break down what I did and how I did it. And so, you know, at some point during that kind of like downward phase after I built my initial team, I went online and found Mike Dillard and Tim Irwin. And mm-hmm. Tim Irwin is now my partner. And with Tim, we continue on that legacy now. And so within 2 years of finding Attraction Marketing, I learned how to build the brand, build the following, generate prospects online. And I built a list. I quit my job within 2 years of finding Attraction Marketing in 2008. By 2012, I had my first $1 million year. And since now in 2018, I've been responsible for approximately $20 million in income into my businesses. And it's all thanks to Attraction Marketing. You know, I officially kind of retired from network marketing in 2012. Because, you know, as I was doing Attraction Marketing, it was working for me and I built my six-figure business in network marketing and I helped others do the same. We ran up against a lot of resistance from kind of like the orthodoxy of,
yes.
of you know, the profession that didn't understand what we were doing, didn't like it. So because they didn't understand it, they didn't like it. They were very old school. And so bear in mind, this is back in 2000, you know, six and, you know, 2006 to 2008. And we're running up into all this resistance negativity. So if you think things are bad today, imagine, you know, back then,
right.
And so that was it, but I chose to, whatever, I'm going to do it anyway, align myself with a company that, was pro Attraction Marketing and, you know, went off to the races. And, you asked me what had me commit to like helping others, continue doing Attraction Marketing. And for a while, Attraction Marketing almost went away. You know, many of us had been beaten up so much by people at the top of network marketing who had built their businesses like 20, 30 years ago mm-hmm. that, it just for many of us, and even Mike Dillard chose to leave because he couldn't stand the pettiness of so many, leaders in network marketing. And so Mike chose to kind of move on to something else and,
right.
Move on to bigger and better things. But you know, Tim and I chose to kind of stay, and even Tim at a certain point kind of withdrew. Because it didn't make sense to be, you know, from a business standpoint, it didn't make sense to be running into these negativity, the threats, people's lives being kind of, you know, messed with regards to their incomes and network marketing. And it's just too much negativity to deal with. And so we withdrew and it was a certain point, you know, my No Excuses brand, even Elite Marketing Pro was becoming more of a generic thing to help all business owners, regardless of their background. But, you know, and it was for a while, there was no voice. There was no counter voice to kind of like the old school way. And I decided that wasn't right, that there was work that was unfinished. And we needed to transform this industry. In fact, we needed to disrupt this profession. And so that's what I've committed myself to doing, disrupting, being that counter voice. You know, when the traditional gurus that are out there, you know, that are slowly at a crawl space adopting technology to kind of, you know, be on the cutting edge, I'm basically calling them out on their BS and saying that is not the cutting edge. I'm here to give people the absolute best opportunity for them to build a brand, take their business online, and have success as quickly as possible. And so we've done that. You know, it's not, you're not only one of our case studies, Julie, you are now a leader perpetuating, you know, this message of attraction marketing. And, you know, Carrie and Brandy, they're rocking it in their network marketing business as well. Yeah. Creating a massive income for themselves over the past year and a half. And so those are the success stories that continue to drive me. Attraction marketing works. It's a very different approach, and you're going to run into resistance. But if you have the courage, you know, nothing can stop you.
Yeah, no. Oh my gosh. I love all that. You guys, was that amazing? Like, just show Ferny love on that, because give him some hearts, because you guys, seriously, you and TJ are like a catalyst for this. And so I'm just following the way, because I felt like it was more painful to continue on doing home parties and three-way calls and not being around with my kids and being gone nights and weekends. And, you know, even if we're on three-way calls, we're not with our children, because we're focusing on the conversation. Right. And so building my business that way, I felt like I just hit a wall, like just complete burnout. And so I was like, there has to be another way. There has to be another way. And Bernie's right. Like, there is going to be pushback and resistance, because some of these leaders and these companies that have been doing it the old school way for so long continue on and saying, nope, home parties, belly to belly, eye to eye is the way that it works. And we are not saying that that does not work. We are not saying that. However, do you want to drive all over to meet people? Do you want to drive all over just for nobody to show up? Or do you want to be able to truly build a laptop lifestyle? Like, we travel all the time. I am constantly traveling. Like, that's the life I want to live with my family, or to going to events. And it's a beautiful thing. Like, this last weekend, I was at an event with my new company. And I'm literally at the pool enrolling people, right? And so not only does attraction marketing work, but in my new company, we build 100% online. And so it's very leveraged. And what attraction marketing, it does is it flips the script. It's like, no, I don't need to go and chase after friends and neighbors and my family. I can now be that magnet to pull these people in by building this brand. And it's funny because I think it was about 6 months ago, there was a leader I heard at a convention stood on stage, and somebody told me this, and she was, you know, shouting, you know, you build your business and then you build your brand. And I'm like, no, you build your brand, and through building your business, you're building your brand. So I feel like it goes hand in hand, because as you build a brand, people know, like, and trust you, right? And the reason why I transitioned out of my last company, not expecting to, but things happen, you guys. And I transitioned out a year ago. Actually, yesterday was my 1 year date, Ernie. And so I transitioned into another company, and people say, how did you fly to the top of this company in 1 year? It's because I was doing attraction marketing and building a brand. And that's where, you know, Fernie's here, because he just wants to see you guys succeed, and be happy and feel fulfilled about it and doing it the right way, and me as well. So thank you for sharing that. I love your story. You guys, he's brilliant. One thing I love about TJ and Fernie is their mind. Like, I could just sit there all day and listen to them, because they're brilliant. They're brilliant marketers. Ferny is brilliant with traffic and lead generation. And that's the stuff that we are not taught as network marketers. We're not taught marketing. And so I think that that is such a crucial part of our business. And yet nobody is learning it. They just want to learn social media and this and that. But no, you really want to understand how to copy, and you want to understand how to market yourself, not your product, your business, your opportunity. Mm-hmm. So thank you, Ferny, for sharing that story. Okay, next question. And I have my questions all here already for Ferny. He doesn't know any of my questions, but all right. what would you say to someone who is either A, just getting started, and why it's so important for them to learn attraction marketing, what you feel your view is on that? And then how does attraction marketing help with lead generation and conversion?
Yeah, that's a great question. And so if you're just getting started, just know that the fundamental skill sets of network marketing will always apply. It's just the question is, how do you apply them? And so you'll notice that people that are effective offline have a kind of a magnetic aura about them. They just attract people to them, and they know how to speak to them in a way that gets people interested, you know, hooks people. And so that's because they've developed these skill sets around salesmanship. And they've also, in some ways, they've created a brand. If you've ever seen, for example, I'll give two examples right now of people that in the old school world who have brands and just whenever they join a new company, attract people. One, drop me a number 5 if you've ever seen a brand new person join your company. They're already successful in their life. They run businesses, or they just know a lot of people. And then all of a sudden, within, you know, a month, they've recruited a few hundred people into their organization from people they already knew, who knew, like, and trusted them because they were successful already. So drop me a number 5 if you've ever observed that. Somebody just joined a new company and all of a sudden, poof, all these people joined them. Well, that's an example of somebody having a brand. Now, they didn't have, they didn't necessarily have an online brand or list, a social media presence, whatever, but they were already successful. They have credibility. They know all these people, and all these people know this person. They know, like, and trust them. And pretty much the assumption is that, hey, if John is, you know, if John, the successful guy, is going to do this business, I'm going to jump in because everything John does seems to, you know, turn into gold. And so that's the presence and the kind of like the aura that this person might have. That is like having a brand, because they already know a lot of people, but those people trust this person. So what doesn't happen in these situations is you don't see all the people that are joining John analyzing the comp plan, analyzing the company financials, doing all this research, doing all the scientific research on the product. They don't do any of that. They may do some, look it over, but what the reason they're joining us because they trust John, this already successful guy. Mm-hmm. So that's all we're trying to do here. We're trying to get, you know, if you're a waiter without any background or kind of credibility in your sphere of influence, you're not going to have that unfair advantage that John has. So what we teach here with attraction marketing is we teach you how to create that unfair advantage out of thin air, regardless of your background, regardless of that. And so the promise or potential of doing that is, like, once you have built a brand, you can do something like what Julie did. You know, Julie joins a new company in December and announces it. And then within 5 months goes to the top of her company. That's the power of having a brand, is that people, you already have a massive group of people, more than that offline John example could ever have. Cause you know, you can only, you know, your brand in that sense can only extend so far, but when you're doing it online and using attraction marketing, it could extend as far and as big as you want. And that's essentially the power of having that unfair advantage. So what we teach is even bigger than what, you know, that, you know, fictitious John example can do. And, you know, it's proven in Julie. And so what I recommend for that new person is to start off with Julie or with us at Elite Marketing Pro and start learning the basics of how you build the brand. Mm-hmm. You know, it's going to start off with you kind of leveraging some existing systems or tools. You know, at EMP, at Elite Marketing Pro, what we can recommend is, hey, you know, attraction marketing is its own profession, its own skill set. It's going to take you about 6 months to a year to truly master it. And mm-hmm. So how about, instead of you know, building out, you know, a funnel, for example, that you kind of start practicing with ours, or you practice with Julie's funnels. She has an affiliate program that you can kind of drive traffic to. You can do free social media, you can do paid social media, and start just kind of getting your your head wrapped around this attraction marketing thing. So step one is essentially the training wheel phase, where you leverage existing online offers. Hopefully they're in your space. So Julie's offers are in the network marketing space. Our offers are in the internet marketing and the network marketing space. And so you start leveraging that, and all your only goal is to start learning the basics of the skill set. But as a result of doing that, you're going to be generating leads. You're going to have people to talk to. Those people are going to have questions about what it is you're promoting or you're offering online. And guess what? Those are your prospects. Those are the people that you can talk to. And if they're already involved in something and they're happy, great. You tell them, keep learning from Julie, keep learning from EMP. And this is how I can support you. And if they're not happy or they're not involved in something, but they're interested in network marketing because you attracted them, then you can talk to them. So that's phase one. You have immediate prospects to talk to. All I did my first year when I started with attraction marketing is I used an existing system, which is, you know, the previous version of Elite Marketing Pro. I was a student just like anybody else. The first year, all I did was just drive traffic. I ran some ads and drove traffic to this the offers that was in there. It was actually the only offer. And that first year, I literally made my first $10,000 online just practicing attraction marketing. And it was just running one ad at a time, very simple. And that's all I did. And the rest of that was, aside from driving the traffic, I was learning. I was, my car became my university. So I was listening to CDs, MP3s, books on tape, trainings that I purchased. Back then it was all audio, no video. I would just be going through all that stuff. And that was my first year. The second phase, and it doesn't have to take you a year. For you guys now, it shouldn't take you more than like 3 months. And then the second phase is start building your brand. So start building the funnel. Like you've seen Julie's presence with regards to building her funnels. There's a page where people can opt in, join your newsletter, and kind of go down the process. That's the what a funnel looks like. And so we teach you how to begin taking over your funnel, taking over your list, so that when you are promoting out there on social media, when somebody requests information, they raise their hand and give you their contact information, you're actually delivering automated messages to them over time that add value to them. And that's the beginning of you building your brand. You start building your list. Mm-hmm. And so that's essentially phase two and that phase can take a while. There's a lot of skill sets in there, but that's you're building your brand, and your brand is essentially backed up by your results. So previously in step one, you were kind of just practicing and promoting some stuff, maybe making a little money, generating leads, talking to prospects, maybe recruiting some of those into your team. Well, guess what? Those results are what now back up the brand. So if you build the list but have no results, then it's really hard to have credibility, and it's really hard to feel good about, you know, building that brand, because it's kind of hollow, right? So our process teaches you how to get results through this process. You start building your brand. And once you start building your brand, now the kind of the script is flipped, where you can send out an email to a webinar where you're going to say you're inviting people to take a look at your opportunity, or maybe you send out a link or an email with an application people can fill out, whatever your process is for having people raise their hand. Now you can do that on a monthly basis, you know, 29 days out of 30 days of the month, you're adding value to people. You're giving them stuff that's useful to them. And then on one of those days out of that month, you invite people to take a look at what you have. And if they are open, then all of a sudden you are hosting a webinar with a few dozen or a few hundred people that can potentially now become new recruits into your business. And so that's the cool thing, is like, once you create that brand and the leverage, you, with a push of a button, you can start recruiting a lot of people every single month into your team. And that's what's happening with Julie. But actually what's happening with Julie is even bigger, because there's the third phase. The third phase of attraction marketing is when you start landing the whales. So once you get, it'll take you about a year to get really good at this stuff. So a year is not a very long time compared to 40 years at a job. So yeah. A year to get really good at this stuff, and at about the 1 year mark, give or take, you'll start having not only other people following you, other leaders in the space will start following you. They'll really get interested in what you're doing, how you're doing it. Because guess what? All these, there's so many leaders in the network marketing space and even leaders outside the network marketing space that now want to learn what you know. Like how is Julie or how is Fernie or how is Lene or Terry or Lourdes? How is Lourdes attracting all these people, building this massive following? I want to learn how to do that, you know? And so they might be leaders in network marketing. They're six-figure earners, multiple six-figure earners, even seven-figure earners. Mm-hmm. And they're like, I want to follow Lourdes. Wow, this is awesome. And so they hop on Lourdes's list and they start learning from you. And then at some point, some of those leaders, something comes up in their life. Their company goes under. They have a disagreement with their upline. They have a disagreement with their company. Or maybe they're just looking for a better opportunity. Or maybe they want to go online, but they can't because of the restrictions within their current company. Whatever the reasons, all of a sudden, somebody on Lourdes's list will, one of those top earners will go, you know what? I want to talk to Lourdes about what she's doing, what company she's in, and they're going to reach out. So what happens is your brand now is so powerful that other top earners, even if they're making more money than you, will mm-hmm. want to join you. Yeah. And so that's essentially like the journey that I just described, the training wheels. Start off simple and we teach you how to start from the very beginning, no experience. Take over your list and then start landing the whales. That's what's happening with Julie right now. You know, Julie over the past few months has, you know, I think sponsored half a dozen six-figure earners, half a dozen seven-figure earners mm-hmm. into her organization. And they've all of them reached out to you, right, Julie?
Yes.
So it's not Julie poaching or Julie trying to approach people. Mm-hmm. It's people raising their hand and going, Julie, I love what you're doing. I want to be a part of what you're doing. You are in alignment with where I want to go. How do I get started? And that's ultimately the dream. And like not the dream, the promise of what you're headed. And it can happen pretty quickly with Brandy and Carrie, who literally started with us exactly 2 years ago. I think Carrie has recruited 4 six-figure earners into her organization. Brandy has recruited 2 six-figure earners and 1 seven-figure earner onto her organization. They're both making multiple six figures now, 2 years later. So my question for you guys that are listening right now is if Julie and I gave you a blueprint for your first 12 months to master attraction marketing and your first, and then the following 12 months have the blueprint to not only be sponsoring people in droves, but attracting the whales, attracting leaders. If we showed you how to invest 2 years of your life so that you're set for the rest of your life, and if you'd want that, drop us a number 7 if you'd be okay with us showing you that blueprint and if you'd be willing to commit to it. So, you know, drop a 7 if you're willing, if want us to show it to you and if you're willing to commit to it. Because, you know, I know I was a little long-winded right now, but that what I just revealed is the attraction marketing blueprint. And it is very different from what is being taught by the network marketing orthodoxy, but yes. It works if you commit to it. And the only person you're focused on serving are first yourself, your family, and ultimately your team. And you have to keep those things in mind because you're upline, because they're afraid of losing you. They're going to be pushing against it. They're going to be advocating against you doing this. I'm an advocate and Julie's an advocate for you and your business. Yeah. And this is the best way we know on how to build a network marketing business and a brand.
Yeah. No, I mean, all of that is just amazing. And I know we might have some people here like, what is driving traffic? And that's okay, because you'll learn. You'll learn. Yeah. You'll learn what it is. But just think of it this way. If I could kind of like give you like this bird's eye view of what he means is basically you have a message and you're running, you basically get your message in front of your perfect prospect. So then in turn, your prospect reaches out to you and they could be anywhere in this world. So I am building a team globally. In my last company, I wasn't able to do that. Let me put this into context. In my last company, I had a majority of my team that lived in my vicinity, build locally, grow globally, right? Now, with doing attraction marketing and the way that we are growing, and we have a system, you have to have a system for your team to duplicate, as well as you have to have a system for the attraction marketing system as well. So you have a system on both sides.
Yep.
I have thousands of people on my team building, and I think three of them live by me. Everybody else is global. So I have a US team all across the States. I have a UK team. I have a team in Canada. I have a team in New Zealand and a team in Australia right now. No joke. Like, I have these amazing teams all over the world in 1 year. How do you think that happened? Well, that happened because I was getting my message in front of these people through utilizing sponsored ads. And yes, we teach both organic and paid traffic. I understand, like, people want to know both ways. We teach both ways, right? Like, we'll teach you how to get more engagement organically, and then we also teach you how to run traffic. And that's what Fernie is saying. Like, you could get your message in front of your perfect prospects, so then they become like this magnet to you, and then they reach out to you. Like, it's a beautiful thing.
Yeah,
It's a beautiful thing.
I'll put it this way, Julie. I'll put it this way, because you teach social media recruiting better than I've seen anyone teach it in this space, and I've
Thank you.
reviewed all the courses.
Thank
And
you.
so Julie teaches the concept of doing a lifestyle post. So posting something related, like that's basically showcasing the result of her hard work, or it's showcasing the result of her helping somebody else achieve something in their life. And so if Julie helps somebody, so let's say make an extra $1,000 a month, for example. Julie helps that. Not, let, let's go even more. Julie helps somebody create a part-time income. So let's say it's $2,500 a month, or that she helped them in their business. So she puts out on a post, "I'm so proud of Mary. Over the course of the 6 months that I've been working with her, she's managed to create an additional side income so that she can supplement the income that her husband is already bringing in through his job." Now they're able to, do this, this, and this. They're able to take a vacation, whatever the result is. And
Right.
so, you're just basically talking about and of the result and how happy you are for the person that achieved that result. So what happens is now people who are following you on social media, who are your friends or followers, some of them are your friends and family, but not necessarily, see that post and go, "Hey, I want to learn how to do that." And they start private messaging Julie and go, "Hey, Julie, how did you help Mary do that? Because I've been looking for something that can bring in some extra income. Can you help me?" And so it's as simple as that. You put out there a post that showcases a result that is real, and then you invite people to basically private message you to request more information. And so that's all that's happening with social media recruiting. How you kind of level it up to the next level is, now imagine putting that type of post on a business page. So the exact same post, but now you can hit a button, spend $5. So now it's shown to millions of Robert Kiyosaki or Robert or John Maxwell's audiences, or think of any guru out there that has a Facebook presence. Imagine being able to push a button and say, "Show this post to all these people." And now all of a sudden, it's not just your friends that are seeing the post. It's millions of people you don't know who now will be requesting more information about what you're doing.
It's
That in essence
amazing.
is what attraction marketing is, on the beginner stage. That's what we essentially teach you to do as a beginner. Now, I described it in a very condensed way. There are things you need to learn. There are skills you need to learn, but it's a heck of a lot easier than hunting people down at the mall, prospecting people at the mall, even dealing with your warm market, your friends and family who are going to be negative anyway, who have no business being in business anyway. Forget the pain and the brain damage of doing all that. If we can teach you some skill sets where now you can get a message like what you would normally do in a social media recruiting post, and you can put it out to millions of people who are very targeted, is that more appealing to you than, doing it the old school way? I think so.
Yeah, if that's more appealing, I need you to drop yes in the comments, because I think that that is a heck of a lot more appealing. And I know for a fact, because I built my fan page up to almost, I'm near 60,000 fans and followers. And you guys, it's not just about having fans and followers. It's about what you do with them. And I engage with them and I build relationships. Like, I know my fans and followers. It's because I've spent time there. But get this, I only need to spend 10 minutes on my social media over, you know what I mean? Like, I do Facebook Lives. I create, you know, the memes, inspirational memes. I'll share my blog posts, right? Like, there's certain things, like I think I've mastered how to grow a fan page. And it's something I teach, because like, it's so flipping cool that you could just push a button, spend what it costs for a cup of coffee, and get your freaking message to anywhere in the world, like, and attract these people to you. It's mind blowing, Fernie. It's mind blowing.
If people learn,
changes the game.
Yeah. If network marketing, if people learn nothing else about attraction marketing, forget the funnel building, forget, you know, everything I described that might have gone over your head. If you simply learn what we just described, creating a business page, which takes you like 3 minutes, knowing how to set up a post, push a button, and then invite people to private message you if they want to learn more, get more information. And all of a sudden you start having, you know, 5 messages per day popping into your inbox of people that are interested in what you're doing. If that in and of itself is worth it, because we just solved the number one problem in network marketing, with lack of prospects. And, you know, and so now you can focus on every other aspect of your business, because you no longer run out of prospects ever again.
Yeah. And I want to hit one more thing, and then we're going to talk about the summit, because this is amazing. But real quick, you guys, I have to address this because I get asked this all the time, and Fernie will back me up here. So I get all the time, fan page, you guys, fan page and business page are the same thing. Okay. But I call it a fan page. I actually call it a passion page, but let's just go for the sake of argument, fan page. Fan page versus group. I want to make this very clear. Well, I had someone ask me this the other day, and they're just starting out. And I'm like, who would you invite to your group? Please tell me. And she started laughing, because the reason why I'm so strong about a fan page is that is your upfront attraction marketing. It's a public page. It's away from your warm audience. You're building a whole new audience. When I started my fan page, I'm like, I don't want to build with my Aunt Betty and my grandma and my, you know, my friends. I blew through my friends. I need fresh people. I need new people. I want to go where nobody knows me and I could start over. And I started from scratch. A fan page is public. A fan page, you could drive traffic to it. A fan page, you could do all the stuff that Fernie and I are explaining about attraction marketing. You guys, a group is phase two. A group is where you have these relationships. You're starting to maybe offer them maybe some other things. Maybe you start creating courses or coaching or what have you. You guys, a group is closed. It's private. That is where you continue on with building relationships. And I know there's this whole fan page versus group thing lately. And I want you to understand that a group is private. A fan page is public. Fan page, you'll continuously pull people in and you'll be able to just start building that relationship and get them attracted to you for what it is that you have going on, right? Mm-hmm. And building your brand. So I don't know why I keep getting this question all the time. I just wanted to address that. And I don't know if you're agreeing with me, if you want to disagree with me, but.
No, that's exactly right. A fan page is public.
It's needed for a business. You
know, all the companies in the world have a fan page, have a business page. They're the same thing. Mm-hmm. And so they're just, if you want to follow, give me a hot new company that's out there right now that you're buying from Julie. What company? Give me a name of one.
That I'm buying. What do you mean?
Yeah, like, clothing company, health company. Who are you following? Who are you buying from right now?
We'll just say White House Black Market.
White House Black Market.
Yeah, it's a nice clothing line. Yes.
Okay, it's a clothing line, and they have a fan page, a business fan page?
Yes, they do.
Okay, so that is their public fan page. So you can follow them so that they can keep you in the loop. If you can get message from them, whatever they post on a daily basis, you can see that in your newsfeed. If they have any specials, you can see it in your newsfeed. Now,
yep.
that is not a community. You're just getting basically messages from them in your newsfeed. A group is something where you, like, it's almost like inviting somebody into your house. You invite them into this group, it's private, and now you get to enter. So if you, Julie, started the group, or if White House Black Market started a group, and they invited you into this group, now you can actually have back and forth conversations mm-hmm. with White House Black Market. You can have back and forth conversations with other people that are right. part of their community. And that is happening within the group. It is different from their public, essentially message board, their fan page.
Because they're displaying the sales and maybe discounts and promos, and they want to drive sales right there. So they're like offering you all this stuff over here. And I love that analogy, because every serious business has a business page. And so, that's awesome. I had a thought there. I lost it. But White House Black Market. Yeah. So here's a cool thing, you guys. Listen to this. So White House Black Market is also, if you drive some traffic, I could say, hey, you know what? I'm looking to attract women ages 35 to 45 that shop at White House Black Market that are moms to my post. You guys, how brilliant is Facebook and what we're teaching you right now? Like, can we just get a thumbs up, please? Because that right there, I can attract like my ideal prospect to me, because that's exactly who I'm looking to attract to me for my network marketing business. So, okay.
Yeah, I'll put it this way. Just for that example, let's say most people a lot of people in network marketing have weight loss products. So they're in the health mm-hmm. market, and I usually lead with weight loss because that has mass market appeal. So imagine being able to do a post that talks about all the people you're helping change their life and drop a few pounds. Imagine being able to put that message in front of the followers of Jenny Craig, Weight Watchers, Nutrisystem, weight loss.
Jillian Michaels. Here.
And now all the followers of those people are starting to see your post, and you spend $5 a day so they can see it. Is $5 a day as an alternative to prospecting people at the mall worth it? Would you guys invest $5 per day so that you don't have to go outside to prospect strangers that are going to kind of likely spit in your face? Would you rather just spend those $5 and be able to get in front of your actual target market, people that are actively trying to lose weight, and you're able to offer them a better solution?
Yeah. If you like that way, drop us a fist bump, because I'm going to fist bump you right now, because I love it. I love it. And you guys, it really, here's the thing. It doesn't happen overnight, but mm-hmm. when you learn it, like, it's one of those things that it's always like it's in your intellect. Like, you got it. And like Fernie says, it takes about 6 months to a year to like really get this. Mm-hmm. But how do you want to keep struggling, or do you want to learn this?
Yeah. Yeah. So Julie, people are already asking, all right, how do we get started in attraction? Okay.
So I want Fernie to talk about this. I don't know if you want to, can you talk about the summit? Can you talk about No Excuses Mine and what that is and your vision on that?
Absolutely. And so, guys, you guys were asking, okay, how do we do this? How do we get started in a massive way? How do we take massive action in a short period of time so that we can get up to speed to kind of cut that learning curve? And so the best way I know how to do that is through live training. Every time I've ever been to a live event with a mentor, is when my knowledge, and not only my knowledge, my actionable knowledge, move from here to here in a very short period of time. So that means getting an environment with other people who are up to the same thing, who are positive, not negative, like everyone else around you. And where you're essentially isolated, where there's no distractions, there's no kids, there's no family. We love them, but they can be a huge distraction away from your business. So imagine spending, 3-4 days with us in Las Vegas, fully immersed, learning from the best people in the world on how to build a network marketing business using attraction marketing. And so that is essentially what the No Excuses Summit is. We've been doing the No Excuses Summit since 2010. This is going to be our 9th No Excuses Summit in Las Vegas on June 21st through the 24th. Julie is going to be a trainer there at the No Excuses Summit. She's going to be training starting on Friday. So she's one of our first trainers. And I like to say the word trainers instead of speakers, is because you're not just there to hear some sort of motivational story. In fact, we almost prohibit our speakers from going too deep into their story because we want them to get into the training and the content. And so if you want to learn from myself, you want to learn from the best in the world at attraction marketing, not just social media recruiting, but attraction marketing, mm-hmm. and get insight as to how it is people are building online, then that's what the No Excuses Summit is about. And that's the No Excuses Summit is the only network marketing event that is purely focused on online building strategies and focused on stuff that starts with social media, goes beyond social media. There's so much for you to learn, and you're gonna get a bachelor's degree in attraction marketing in 1 weekend at the No Excuses Summit. And so we're doing something kind of pretty special here, Julie. Tickets for the No Excuses Summit are normally $497. You can go to elitemarketingpro.com/NES and look at the full price there. As a special offer or special opportunity for people here that are following Julie, we want to give you free tickets. So we want to give
you free, how cool is that?
We want to give you free tickets to the No Excuses Summit. All we are asking is a $97 deposit. And then once you submit your deposit, when you arrive at the event, we will give you that money back. So you're going to be there for free. All you have to do is get there to Vegas on June 21st through the 24th. So Julie, how can they actually claim their ticket to the No Excuses Summit?
Yeah.
It's because again, this is an opportunity. It's only available for the next hour. So you guys have 1 hour to take action on this. Mm-hmm. We're going to basically give you a free ticket. You can get as many as you want. You just have to submit the $97 deposit and we'll give you the money back at the event. The only catch is that you have to go to the event. So we won't give you your money back unless you go to the event, because we spend $250,000 doing this event. Yes. All we are asking is that you make a commitment to yourself. And when you arrive at the event, we'll give you $97 back. And you can use that money to, have fun in Vegas, or you can choose to just put it in your pocket, sit down and learn from all the awesome trainers.
Yeah. So you guys, honestly, I went last year. I was honored to speak there last year. And I'm going to tell you right now, it is life-changing for your business. It will literally take your business to the next level. I cannot even begin to tell you the training that is provided there. And so I want to fast track, and so does Ferny. We want to fast track your success, right? So get your butts there, get this free ticket. Don't even think about it. Do the flight later. You will make this work. So if you want that ticket, I need you to drop Vegas. I mean, how hard is that? Vegas, drop Vegas in the comments, you guys, and you will get the link. You'll get my link to the free ticket to No Excuses 9. And I will tell you, it wasn't just me that it's been life-changing for. Like Bernie said, this is their ninth year. I know a ton of people that have gone through your training. I mean, we're talking like Ray Higdon, Tanya Eliza, Cesar Rodriguez, right? Like a ton of people have gone and trained with Ferny and Tim Irway. And so now you know why they're so successful in their business in the online space. And so, I mean, I'm honored to be here again. And thank you. Thank you so much for doing this for our community, to offer these tickets for free. Mm-hmm. So you guys, seriously, I don't know. Can you guys show Ferny some love and say thank you, because this is pretty incredible. So just drop the word Vegas in the comments. You'll get the link to it. You have 1 hour to get these tickets for free. And then the price will go up after that. So if you're just unsure, just drop Vegas and just look at it. Look at that, the page. I think you have a video on that page, right, Ferny, talking about it?
Yeah, you'll get all the information on who's training there, who's speaking.
The speakers.
Nadia Melton is training there. Tanya Eliza, all our friends, the people that are rocking it in their business online, multiple 6- and 7-figure earners will be training at this event. Just drop Vegas. It's our, basically because of Julie, we're able to make this offer. This is not a public offer. You won't see ads of us promoting or giving away tickets. The only reason we are willing to give a ticket away is because we know that you trust Julie And you're going to be as committed as somebody that paid $1,000 to be at that event, because Julie is imploring you to like go for your benefit. Mm-hmm. And so when you get your ticket, you know, if you want to upgrade to some of the extra stuff we'll be doing, like we'll have some parties and networking events, you can choose to upgrade to that stuff as well if you want. You can choose to even purchase the recordings ahead of time, a pre-order, a special offer, so you can actually not only be there, but buy the recordings of it. Just know that being at a live event versus watching the recording, completely different.
Completely. Remember, you're
fully immersed for a full 3 days, so your learning will go up exponentially. Your ability to take action will go up exponentially. Your level of commitment to your business will go up exponentially. You know, online courses, online videos, recordings, there are a dime a dozen. So many people are training online. We are here to give you an experience that forces you to take action. And so that's what we do at the No Excuses Summit. We're there to serve you. And there's no other way we can possibly get this many top earners in the network marketing space we're building online, get them together to give you a training in a very short period, give you training over the course of 3 days. There's no other way to do it other than to have it be at a live event and having you there committed and ready to learn. So
yeah,
just all I had to do is drop Vegas and you have an hour to, you know, get your ticket. If you want to, let other people know about this, then immediately share this video with your friends. Tell them drop Vegas, you know, have them and have them be your buddy that's going to go there with you at that event, because it's going to be life changing. And so, Julia.
Yeah, you know what? I think I'm going to do something for those of you that share it. I did this a couple weeks ago and I had a ton of shares on a video. It was really cool. So anyone that shares this, I'm going to raffle off a 20-minute coaching call. And so I actually, the winner of it a couple weeks ago, her and I just did that call yesterday. The wonderful Lisa and I raffled off that coaching call. So anyone that shares this out, because honestly, that's why we're here. We want to help business owners build their business faster, more efficient. And we want to help them give you that roadmap, just like I was given that roadmap, right? Again, people look at me, you've had all this success. I've learned from that, right? So show up in your business, show up in your life. And I really highly encourage you to get your butts into those seats, because I promise you, you will not regret it. I had a ton of people go last year and they said, Julie, this was like the best event I've ever been to my business. I don't run weekend masterminds, right? I don't run my own weekend masterminds because I send people to No Excuses. It's yearly. It's once a year. That's all you get is once a year to attend this. So if you miss this opportunity this year, guess what? You have to wait all the way 1 year to next June if you're going to host another one, which hopefully you will, or else I'll kick your butt, Ferny, because they're so great. but yeah, share this out. And if you share, I want you to put share in the comments and I will raffle off my own 20-minute coaching call with you next week. Okay. So awesome. Yeah, we just got to share the love. So yeah, Ferny, go ahead.
Again, Julia, just so people have perspective, because it's really easy for people to go, well, Julie, you're already successful. You have a big brand. Of course, you're going to be able to recruit a lot of people into your business and do all the wonderful things you do. Guys, Julie started with us with less than 1,000 people on her email list, less than a couple of thousand people that are following her on Facebook, yep. Mm-hmm. On her fan page. And over the course of the last year and a half, it's exploded. She took massive action. So I'm not promising you Julie's results, but if you're even willing to take, you know, a quarter of the action that Julie took in her business, then I guarantee you it's worth it, you know, and, you know, put the negative conversations that are happening in your head right now about, I don't know if I can do this, or you're doubting yourself, you're doubting your ability to get there. Like, what if your life depended on it? What if, you know, something catastrophic would happen if you didn't go there? You know, we move so quickly and react so quickly when things go bad in our lives. And I tend to kind of hold back when there's a promise of something potentially good happening in our lives. And that's unfortunate about our human nature, is that we're willing to move heaven and earth to avoid something bad happening to us. How about you actually be willing to move heaven and earth to have something really good happen to you?
Oh, I love that.
Right here. You know, I know you know, getting to Vegas for some of you might not be easy, but I've witnessed people do some extraordinary things under, you know, to get there. There's a guy that I know that went to No Excuses too, that he didn't have the money to go. So what did he do? 6 months out, he basically went around his neighborhood, small town, collected scrap metal in his truck, loaded in his truck, collected enough scrap metal so he can buy a ticket to No Excuses. You don't have to buy a ticket to No Excuses. Then the next 3 months after he bought this ticket, so he can pay for the gas to drive from Connecticut to Las Vegas, he collected more scrap metal, cashed in that scrap metal. That was the money that he was able to do to get to and from Vegas from Connecticut. He drove across the country. He was sitting front row and he was the happiest dude there at that event. So, awesome. You know, what's the excuse? You know, move heaven and earth to have something really good happen in your life, as opposed to waiting for something bad to happen. And I promise you, if you take action towards, you know, what potentially can go well in your life, then you'll have a lot fewer, you know, of those times when really bad things are happening to you. Most of the time, those bad things have to do with your financial situation. And so, you know, when your financial situation is dire, all that meant is that you didn't take enough action previous to that so that you can avoid being in that negative situation. So we're giving you an opportunity to be proactive for some of you for the first time in your life, to actually turn, you know, your whole business and your fortunes around.
Yes. Awesome. Thank you. Oh, I love that. Move heaven and earth, not for the negative that's happening, but for the positive. And I love that. And that's so true. And I don't want you guys to discredit this because it is a free ticket. We're doing this as a gift to you to help get you there. But find the value in it. Please find the value in it, because I'm telling you, I promise it is life-changing those 3 days.
Melissa, you know, I implore, well, do whatever you can to get there. But if you want to have this training, if you want to get started on this journey, private message Julie and her on our fan page, and her support team will provide you some information to at least get you going and starting to learn this. Eventually, it will take a live event, live training for you to actually kind of make some big steps in your business. So, you know, I'm not going to lie and say that if you don't go to this event, you know, there's no chance of you ever succeeding in your business. I'm not going to say that. There's always ways for you to make progress. What I'm saying is that the biggest leaps in where you can kind of collapse time and make the most progress in as quick as time as possible is at a live event. And that's the reason all our mentorship programs, you know, within our company, Elite Marketing Pro, we include in every mentorship program live events that people can go to, workshops, events like the No Excuses Summit. And we have other events as well. It's because we know that the biggest breakthroughs will happen at live events, because that's where you're fully immersed and your subconscious, conscious, and your body are all in alignment or in one direction.
Yes. Yeah. So true. So true. I've had some breakdowns at some live events, as you probably remember. But yeah, please, if you have any questions, feel free to private message me on the fan page. If you want to learn more about this whole attraction marketing thing, and also drop Vegas, if you want to check out the page to learn more about No Excuses 9. And again, if you share this out, I will raffle off a live coaching session with moi for 20 minutes in my schedule is slam, but I will make certain that I do this for all of you, because that's how important this is. Your success is my success. And so I'm super excited about this. And
one more thing. I see people asking questions.
Yes, go ahead.
These are very good questions.
Yes, please.
So guys, after you get your ticket, you're going to have a phone call with a coach of ours who's going to get you into our private community. In that community, we have a post already set up for people that are looking for roommates to bunk with in Vegas. It's going to happen at the M Resort in Las Vegas. It's just a property about 15 minutes outside of the Strip. It's a beautiful hotel. It's very luxurious, very hip. And we own the entire hotel. There's no other event happening at that hotel except our event. And so Woo-hoo. We have all event space. It's going to be awesome. They have world-class restaurants. And so we provide you a link where you can book a discounted room with that hotel. You can't get that discount anywhere else. You'll get it through us. And if you're looking for roommates to split a room with, or split a room with three people or whatever it is, then there's a thread inside of our community where you can actually find roommates and somebody to kind of split the cost with of being there. So we provide you the resources. So when you get your ticket, make sure you sign up for our Ignition coaching program, because on that on your first call with our coach, they're not only going to kind of explain a few things to you, they're also going to add you to our private group. And in that group is where you can be a part of our broader community, learn more about, you know, what we do here at EMP. But more immediate to your needs is you're able to connect with other people who are going to go to No Excuses, find some people to bunk with, and make some new friends.
Yeah. Some major friendships I know of came out of last year's No Excuses, that people that did this exact same thing, and they found roommates and just grew some awesome friendships again. And that's what it's all about, because it's about everyone helping one another out. Right. And it's growing those relationships, getting to know people, as well as furthering and advancing your own education and knowledge about what we're doing here in the online marketing space, attraction marketing, and with EMP. So with that being said, Ferny, do you want to answer any other questions? I don't know if there's anything else on there.
Someone asked what the hotel was. It's the M Resort in Las Vegas.
Yeah. So
the M. Beautiful. M. It's gorgeous. And so they're pretty awesome, and they're pretty much allowing us to take over the entire hotel for one weekend.
Yeah. And you get to meet me. Hello. Hello. You get to meet me on the other side of this computer screen or phone. And we'll have a drink together. Woohoo. Ferny, you're amazing. Thank you so much for being here. I'm honored again to have you. I love you. And everything that you provide to just the network marketing profession as a whole. And so again, thank you for spending, my gosh, just over an hour with us. You guys, we're blessed to have him. Can we please show Ferny some love? Please drop him some comments, let him know he's loved. And I know we're on a bit of a delay here, but it will catch up eventually. And if you're on the replay, drop hashtag replay. I'd love to connect with you as well. So with that being said, Ferny, have an awesome day. I know you're a couple hours behind me, so it's still, well, now it's probably afternoon by you, but.
It's 11 a.m.
Yeah, 11 a.m. Yeah, still mid-morning. It's the afternoon here. Enjoy your day. Love you, friend. Thank you so much.
Love you too, Julie. Thank you so much for having me, for everything you do. And congratulations, like huge congratulations on everything you've accomplished over the past year and a half. Like, it's literally been a year and a half since we started working together.
Yeah.
And man, it's night and day just doesn't do it justice. It's, you know, you've done some pretty special things, and I'm proud of you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Don't make me cry. Sometimes I end up crying on some of these. Oh my God. Love you. Thank you. Thank you for all of you that were here again. Drop Vegas and get this out. Share it. All right.
Bye guys.
Bye. Love you.